Good morning. What it do, everybody? What it do, all my crew? What's up on Instagram? What's up on Facebook? Hey, hey, everyone. Come on in, come on in. What's up, everybody? What's up, what's up? Hey, hey, everyone, come on in. What it do, all my crew? Hey, Aunt Bev. Hey, everyone, come on in, come on in. It's time to pray. I am here unfiltered. I've got my fight gear on. I've got no hat, no lashes, no makeup, no eyebrows. I'm coming on here with my family. This is how I would sit around with my family and talk about the Lord, pray over my friends, and just get real. So that's what I'm doing today. I thought about, you know what? I did chemo yesterday. I did round 10 of chemo, guys. Give me a heart party because we are pumping through my chemo sessions. I have 6 more to go, and then we move on to the next phase of this journey. And so I did chemo yesterday, so I've got all of the skin stuff, I've got the swelling, I've got all the things, but it's not gonna stop me from getting with my crew right here. You guys see, I'm getting hair. Do you guys see this? I shouldn't be growing hair right now, guys. I'm in the middle of chemo. That's like another miracle in and of itself. I have 6 more weeks of chemo left, and I'm already growing my hair back. It looks a little like there's bald spots, but they're not. These are like bleach, like all of the hair is the same length. It's just I've got bleach blonde hair, and then I've got dirty blonde hair. So I need Jesus to help me with that. I need him to like make all of it the same color so it all looks even, right? But that's another miracle. Yes, it's going to be so thick and beautiful when it grows out. I believe it. It already is, guys. When you get me in the sunlight, my hair is like so blonde and so thick in the back. Brandon's like, oh my gosh, my kids keep touching my head. I shouldn't be growing hair right now, but God. So really excited about it. You guys hit share. Do me a favor. I can't get this out without your help. So tag somebody down below, hit share, do that for me. Comment shared when you do it. We are going to pray today. And today I want to specifically reach through the screen to somebody who is going through sickness, to somebody who is fighting an illness, a disease, an autoimmune disorder. Yes, Jesus, help my hair. It's already, you know what? I'm blessed and I'm thanking him for what I've got right now. I shouldn't have any stitch of hair on my head right now. So thank you, Lord, for allowing it to start growing already. But you guys hit share. Get somebody in here who is needing healing. Get somebody in here who has been struggling with an illness, with a disease, with COVID, with maybe something, a disease that you can't even see, an autoimmune disorder, fibromyalgia. Did I just totally butcher that word? I always get it wrong. So y'all don't, hey, y'all know what I'm trying to say. So get somebody in here. I did not come on here unfiltered in my PJs to not get as many people as I can in here to pray over them today. I've got a word for you. If you don't know who I am, let me go ahead and introduce myself. My name is Alyssa Holt, and my ministry is Unfiltered, and I talk about all the things. And my goal in life, what God has called me to, is to pick people up out of the dirt of their life, the things that have told them they can't, they never will, they shouldn't, they're never going to be heard, they're disqualified, they're destined for nothing but disaster. And my call is to take those people by the hand and to pick them up and not let them stay where they are. By sharing my story, you guys, if you don't know, I wrote a book called Unfiltered, Walking Through Dirt While Embracing Your Destiny. Let me put my link down here on Facebook so you can get a hold of that. And you can go pick it up on Amazon, Kindle, on my website, guys. I've got a podcast, Unfiltered with Alyssa Holt. I've got a YouTube channel that is all my unfiltered chats. And I've got a mentorship a MentorU that is starting back up this Monday. This Monday, $25 a month to be a part of my personal crew. That's all. Just $25 a month for 30 days with me, with my crew. Every Monday night on Zoom call, we are getting together with my crew, and you're going to be a part of a private Facebook page where you can cultivate relationships. There's going to be daily challenges. You're going to receive all kinds of things from me, videos, devotionals, worksheets to help you journal and work through your life. I'm there to encourage you. If you don't have a voice in your life to help you get up out of the dirt, let me be that for you. Ask God, you know what? Can I do $25 a month to join a crew? I have so many of y'all that reach out to me and say, I don't have a church. I don't have anybody to be my voice, to be a voice in my life. I don't have anybody to surround me with good influences. My job in life is to create safe places for us to be unfiltered and talk about the real life things, the things that nobody wants to talk about, but not allow each other to stay there, to pick each other up from that moment and to move forward. Right now, and you can do all of that right there on my link. BrandonandAlyssa.lifeforge/store. Sign up now. There are limited spots available. I am keeping this thing kind of small because I, right now going through cancer, I like to pour into people one-on-one as much as I can, and we'll probably open those spaces up. You can sign up for MentorU any day of the week, any time of the month, any time of the day. So you don't have to sign up for it at a specific time to get the month. You can sign up anytime and get you a month from the time that you sign up. But we are starting our first Monday this Monday. So sign up, be a part of this. You're going to get access to me every single day. And then you're going to do personal private Zoom calls just like this, but way more deep, way more detailed. And we talk about some stuff over there that y'all want to be a part of. So hey, Tab, what's up, everybody? Thank you for joining. Hit that share button. We're going to pray. I don't know what you guys are dealing with. I just told everyone as y'all were popping in, I just finished my 10th round of chemo yesterday. Today, I thought about putting my makeup on and getting dressed up for you guys, but I thought, why would I do that when I'm just going to be laying around my house all day, right? Yeah, like, so cheers to being unfiltered. Let's just take a drink of our coffee real quick. If you guys are ready, throw those coffee cup emojis down below. You guys know the drill. Give me a heart party. I've got a word for you. I've got four practical steps while you are waiting. How many of you have been waiting for healing in your mind, in your will, in your emotions, in your physical body? If you've been waiting for healing in some sort of way, I want you to comment down below me. Do that real quick while I take a drink of this coffee. And then we're going to jump in to our scripture for today. I want you guys to hit that share button. And I just want to pray over you. I just want to speak life over you today. You're not alone. And so that's what we're going to do. I see the me's. I see the coffee cups. What's up, everybody? What's up? What's up? Hey, Instagram, if y'all don't follow me on Facebook, you need to go follow me because I got my big crew most of the time over here on Facebook. But Facebook, if you don't follow me on Instagram, you need to come follow me on Instagram because there's some stuff I do over there that y'all don't see on Facebook at The Alyssa Holt. So awesome. I see you guys. I see you guys. So here's the scripture for today. I want y'all to type it down below. Okay. Psalm 27, 13 through 14. Psalm 27, 13 through 14. I'm not going to talk a long time today. Today I'm resting, but I want to speak life into you. I'm trying to be more diligent with coming on here. Even if, you know, for a little bit there, guys, I was like, it's tough showing people this side of cancer, right? It's tough showing people. Not everybody is willing to get on and show you this side of cancer. Ain't no lashes, ain't my eyebrows falling out. I got spots all missing. Compared to my eyebrows beforehand, they are pretty much gone. But compared to most people's eyebrows during cancer, I got some. So I'm raising a glass to that. It's not easy showing up in the midst of a journey. It's not easy showing up in the midst of an obstacle. And maybe you're there right now. Maybe you feel like, Alyssa, I don't know how to show up right now in the midst of the journey I'm facing. I don't know how to show up in the midst of the thing that I am going through. It is hard for me to get out of bed. It is hard for me to want to even pray. Like, I try to pray, Alyssa, but the words won't even come out of my mouth because I'm angry at God. I'm angry at the situation I am going through. I am mad as hell. And can I tell you something? It is okay to be mad as hell. Maybe that's not something somebody will tell you, but it is not okay to allow hell to drive you mad. Did you just hear what I just said? It is okay to be mad as hell, but it's not okay to allow hell to drive you mad. I know that some of y'all have woke up today not understanding, not knowing how, needing some extra love and support because you just don't know what to do next. And we are fixing to pray over you. We're fixing to read the scripture, Psalm 27, 13 through 14. I'm fixing to give you 4 steps to get through the waiting. Today, my one-liner for you is stop waiting and start claiming the thing that you need in your life. Stop waiting and start claiming the thing that you need in your life. How can I say that? Because I'm sitting here in front of y'all completely unfiltered, and every single day I wake up and I don't say I'm waiting for my healing from cancer. I say I am healed because the word of God says I am healed. Faith says if God said it, I believe it. And that settles it. Faith goes against what you see. Faith is standing on the word of God, even when the obstacle, the reality, the thing looks more real than what the word of God says. Stop waiting and start claiming. You got to use this right here, guys. You got to open up your mouth and declare what the word of God says. Hey, Daddy, love you. I am so much of an advocate. And every time I get on here, I am going to continue saying it till my dying day, till you get it. It is not God that is waiting to heal you. Did you just hear what I said? He did everything that he could possibly do when he sent Jesus on the cross to die for your, not only your sins, but your healing. Do you hear what I am saying? It is funny to me. Listen to this. And we're going to jump into this scripture because I've got 4 things I want to share with you. If you have somebody in your life that needs healing, tag them right now. Share it right now, guys. I am fixing to pray over you. We are fixing to speak life. But listen, it is funny to me how we believe that the cross has been given for our salvation. And we believe that the moment that we ask Jesus into our heart, that we are saved. We believe that. We believe that he is in our heart. We say all of this verbiage, right? Jesus is in our heart. We've been saved. I don't say that anymore. I'm not giving my life to God. What can God do with my life? I'm receiving the life of Jesus. The moment you got saved, you received the life of God inside of your life. And we can be totally okay with understanding salvation is like that and salvation is ours. But when it comes to our healing, we look at that same cross and we question whether or not healing is ours. We don't question salvation, but we question healing. And the same cross that saved you is the same cross that heals you. It was done for your salvation and it is done for your healing. Stop waiting and start claiming what the word of God says that you can have. Did you hear that? I am sitting in front of you going through a battle. Didn't get all prissied up this morning. I am raising a glass in real life struggle. I am shaking like a leaf this morning. My body is tired. This round of chemo has hit me weird. It's hit me different than the other rounds of chemo have with Taxol. But I'm here. I'm showing up because I believe I prayed over you this morning and I asked God that the ones that needed to be on this call with me would be on this call with me. If we don't hit 100 people, we don't hit 100 people. But I believe you are here for a purpose. I believe that you are here for a reason. And I want to speak life over you. You guys ready? So Psalm 27, 13 through 14. Psalm 27, 13 through 14 says, yet I totally trust you to rescue me one more time so that I can see once again how good you are while I'm still alive. I'm talking to the sick today. I'm talking to those of you who are sitting in a moment for healing. You need to declare this. I totally trust you. Put your hand over your heart. God, I totally trust you to rescue me one more time. Say it. So that I can see once more how good you are while I'm still alive. And then he goes on to say, here's what I've learned through it all. Don't give up. Don't be impatient. Be entwined as one with the Lord. Be brave and courageous. And never lose hope. Listen to me, somebody. Yes, keep on waiting, for he will never disappoint you. He will never disappoint you. Put your hand on your heart and say, you will never disappoint me. Stop waiting and start claiming what the word of God says that you can have. He will never disappoint you. I know that it is weird. It is strange. It goes against logical explanation. It goes against what normal people would do to proclaim that you are healed when you are sitting in a chair every single week getting pumped with poison and shots. Yesterday, I got a shot that's the size of a screwdriver, 18 gauge needle to put me in menopause, 31 years old, going through menopause. Your estrogen levels are here, and then they pump you with a shot and bam, you are all the way at rock bottom going through menopause. It is awful. It's there to protect my fertility, but it's also there to do hormone therapy for me because my issue was fueled through estrogen. So it is goes against logical explanation to say I'm not waiting for my healing as I sit in a chemotherapy chair, but to say I am claiming what the word of God says. It goes against logical explanation when you have a doctor's report in front of you that says something that contradicts the word of God. But guys, I've said it before. My daddy says it all the time. I got it from him. You cannot rewrite the word of God based on your experiences. If the word of God is true, then the word of God is true. No matter what you're looking at, no matter what you're facing, no matter what your reality says, no matter what your situation says, I cannot rewrite the word of God based on my experience. Well, I'm going through cancer. So maybe God doesn't heal. Well, I've got an autoimmune disease that I've lived with my whole life. So maybe God doesn't heal. Well, I saw mama, daddy, and grandma all die of the same thing that I just got diagnosed with. So maybe God doesn't heal. No, if the word of God is yes and amen, that's when his yes collides with your amen. Be it unto me according to your what? Will. If the word of God is yes and amen, that's his yes colliding with your amen. So be it. So be it, God. You said yes and I'm saying amen. I believe it. The word of God says it. That settles it. I will not be swayed by what I see, what I feel, what I hear. I am moved only by the word of God. And guys, can I tell you, it is not easy. Can I tell you, I have my bad days. Go watch my YouTube channel. You will see me cry. You will see me get in my feels. You will see me deal with the emotions, the real life of cancer. I wrote a whole book showing you the real life of divorce and rape and church hurt and addiction. And I share with you guys journal entries of my personal, unfiltered journal entries going through real life hell, because I believe that nothing can grow without dirt. No fruit can grow without dirt. But even in my feels, even in my emotions, even in my things, when you watch my YouTube channel and see me go through this journey, I always come right back to what the word of God says. I kind of feel like David sometimes. David's up in his feels all the time in Psalms. He talks about, God, why'd you leave me here to die? And then on the flip side, he's saying, I will live and not die and declare the works of the Lord. He's always complaining, but he always comes back to the word of God. That's why I believe that faith doesn't mean that you have no feelings. Faith doesn't mean that you're numb to feelings. Faith means you take those feelings and you plant them in the dirt of that situation and watch God grow destiny with it, because you're standing on his word more than your worries. You're agreeing with the Savior more than your situation. You're standing on what he says more than what your doctor says. I'm speaking to somebody specifically today who needs healing in their life. We talk a lot about our mind. We talk a lot about other situations, but I'm coming on here to specifically speak to the sick today. You can get my book right there on that link down below on our website. If you want a signed copy, it's on Amazon. It's on Kindle. Go grab you a copy. It's going to bless your life. But guys, listen, you cannot rewrite the word of God based on your experience. And sometimes it's so easy to get distracted by the reality of what we're going through that we forget what God has said. Stop waiting and start claiming what his word says. So we just read Psalm 27, 13 through 14. I'm going to give you, and then we're going to pray. I'm going to give you four things from this scripture that it says to do in your moment of waiting. Because can I tell you, there are moments and seasons of waiting. I am in the middle of a journey, a process, but while I am waiting, I'm claiming what the word of God says. Name of the book, Unfiltered by Alyssa Holt, Walking Through Dirt While Embracing Your Destiny. So the first thing that I want to tell you, you have to do in this season while you are claiming what the word of God says, according to Psalm 27, 13 through 14, it says, don't give up. And don't be impatient. Type that down below. Oops. Dadgum. There we go. Sorry, Instagram. Somebody was trying to call my iPad. Don't give up and don't be impatient. That's the first point. Type it down below. You have to refuse to lose when you are going through something that is hopeless. When you are going through something that seems impossible, you have to refuse to lose. How can I lose when Jesus already won? How can you lose when Jesus already won? I tell myself this all the time when they called me and said, you have breast cancer, Alyssa. You have two tumors, an unidentified spot that we've got to figure out. And we have a lymph node in there that doesn't look good as well. I had to refuse to lose in that moment. I had to make up my mind, how can I lose this battle when Jesus already won, when he stretched his arms out on that cross and said in 2 Peter, by his wounding flowed my instant healing. Not my progressive healing, my instant healing. And I speak that every day. And this hasn't been, sometimes it is progressive, but I'm going to continue to claim it is instant, because in 2 Peter 2:24, it says, by his wounding flowed my instant healing. I have got to never give up, and I have got to not be impatient. I've got to continue to claim what the word of God says is mine. I can't lose when Jesus already won. Somebody needs to put their hand over their heart and say that. I can't lose when Jesus already won. And through, and I'm not telling you something that I have not experienced. Guys, when they come to you and say you have two golf ball tumors in your breast, an unidentified mark, an unidentified spot that we've got to figure out, and a lymph node that looks bad. But I continued to stand on the word. We saw one tumor vanish miraculously before we ever started treatment. So they couldn't even give chemotherapy or any of their doctor stuff the credit for that tumor disappearing. A golf ball sized tumor vanishing out of nowhere. Then I went and tried to get the MRI biopsy for the unidentified spot. And when I got in the MRI machine, the doctor had to come out and tell me, I don't know what happened, but it's gone. Can't biopsy something that's not there. It's not there. And it didn't take me by surprise. And I was able to look at the doctors every single time. Then we got the biopsy on the lymph node. Came back perfect. It's not cancerous. So they went from telling me, you are absolutely going to lose your breast because there's too many things up in there to save this breast, to now they have officially confirmed that my breast is not going to be cut off, that I'm able to do a lumpectomy, that all of these things have happened supernaturally. And then last week, they came and we went to a surgical appointment, and they went to feel the one last tumor that was left. I don't know why God did it. I don't know why, if he took everything else out, why he had to leave one tumor. All I know is that he's allowed me to go through this journey for you. This journey is more about me, not just about me. It's more about you. It's more about the people that I'm going to help get through this because of the walk that God's allowed me to walk out supernaturally while I stopped waiting and started claiming what the Word of God says I could have. I didn't give up and I wasn't impatient. I refused to lose because how can I lose when Jesus already won? So I went and they did a breast exam and they said, the doctor was shocked on this last tumor. He said, Alyssa, I can't find it. I can't feel it. It's not there. He said, you don't understand. This is a miracle, the doctor said. The oncologist said it out of his mouth. It is a miracle. He said, your type of tumor, the stage that it is, the grade that it is, the characteristic that it is not supposed to shrink with chemotherapy. It's not, it doesn't happen. Listen to what I'm saying. Just because your doctor says, just because you've watched other people walk through what you're going through and it happened for them a certain way, doesn't mean that has to be your story. Stop claiming other people's stories and experiences for your story and your experience because it's what's supposed to happen. You've got to stand on the Word of God. Do you believe the Word of God more than you believe the situation and other people's experiences and other people's advice? Whose report are you going to believe? And I continued to stand, and I told the doctor from the beginning, you're going to watch this tumor completely shrink. And they told me at the beginning, don't get your hopes up. That's not what this does. Chemo does not shrink this type of tumor. It doesn't do it. And last week they confirmed with a physical exam that they could not feel that tumor at all. He said, I can't find it. We're going to do scans and everything. But even if it's just a little bit in there, it is a miracle because it shouldn't have shrunk. Chemo is supposed to keep it from growing, not to shrink. Not your type of cancer. Not the thing you're going through. I want to look somebody in the face and say, why are you agreeing with the situation more than you are agreeing with the Savior? You can argue the Word of God with me all day, but you cannot argue miracles from God that have been documented and proven by me declaring the word of the Lord, tumors disappearing, vanishing, things happening, reports changing. You can't argue that. You can't argue that. God is a God who does not lie. And I want to prophesy right now over somebody who is sitting up in their bed with some kind of doctor's report and you think you're fixing to lose it all. I want to prophesy over you right now. If you will open your mouth and begin to agree with the word of God and refuse to lose and not give up and not be impatient, you watch God perform everything that his word was set out to perform. You watch it happen. You can take it to the bank. There is no question about it. I can say it because I'm sitting here as a living, breathing testimony, a living, breathing miracle, unfiltered, straight up out of chemo yesterday, swollen, face red, my eyes are all dark, got no lashes. I'm sitting here telling somebody today, if he can do it for me, he can do it for you. Get somebody on here who needs this because we're fixing to pray. The second thing, according to Psalm 27, 13 through 14, that you've got to do in the midst of your waiting is to be entwined as one with the Lord. It says, be entwined as one with the Lord. What does that mean? It means daily relationship, guys. This is common sense, but we don't do it. We don't do it. We don't do it. And then we wonder why God isn't showing up, why we can't hear his voice, because we refuse to set and carve time out every day to spend time with God. If you're a part of my Mentor You, if you need a voice in your life, sign up for it. We start this Monday. And you can sign up any day of the week, any time of the month, any time of the day. But the link is down there. Sign up for Mentor You because we're kicking it off this Monday. But I teach my people that journaling is a vital thing. I give them my journaling technique that I've been doing since 14 years old when I was raped and had to work through some stuff. But I hit hard that a daily relationship with God is vital. Being entwined with God is vital in order to see the word of God come to pass in your life. Because you have to have an ear to hear. You have to have a heart to understand. You have to know what he is saying to you. I had to know what the word of God and what God was specifically saying to me when the doctors were coming to me trying to tell me other things. I had to hear his voice in certain situations. I had to know when to say no to the doctor and when to say yes to God. And I can't do that without being with him every day. He is with me every day. God is with you every day. Even when you screw up, even when you mess up, even when you're sitting in a whole lot of things that you wish you weren't, he is with you every day. He never leaves you nor forsakes you. But sometimes we don't show up. Sometimes we are not present. Sometimes we are not available. And it is a daily thing. You can't expect deliverance when you don't know the deliverer. You can't expect to be delivered out of something when you don't even know the person who is trying to take you by the hand and deliver you out of that thing. You got to hear his instructions. You got to hear the detailed instructions during moments like these, during crucial moments like disease and illness and divorce and loss and infertility. I'm telling you, and I need you to hear me. Daily relationship with God is on you, boo-boo. It's on you. It's not on your spouse. It's not on your kids. It's not on your pastor. It's not on your mama. It's not on your daddy. It's not on your grandma. It's not on the situation you're going through. It's not on the things you're having to work out. You showing up every day to spend time with God is on you. It's on you. Listen to this. The third thing is be brave, courageous, and never lose hope. Type that down below. Somebody type it down below right now. We're fixing to pray. Be brave and courageous and never lose hope. Being brave doesn't mean you don't have fear. Can I just squash that right now? Being brave doesn't mean you don't have fear. Being brave means that you're courageous and your courage comes from the hope of glory. Your courage, the word says that when I am weak, he is strong. And that's something that I've had to stand on during this time. Even this morning, getting on this live, it was not easy for me to get up today. I'm shaken and I'm tired and I'm dealing with some things. Being brave and courageous and being able to stand without fear that God's not going to perform what he says does not mean that you're not going through emotions. It does not mean that you're not going through a situation. It does not mean that you've got everything together. What it does mean is that in my moments of weakness, he is strong. I can lean on him. I can trust him. I can count on him. I can know that he is there to carry me through those moments. Guys, in my moments of weakness, I always go back to my scriptures that we're fixing to pray here in a minute. I'm fixing to pray the same scriptures that I have prayed every single day from the moment that I got the phone call, Alyssa, you have breast cancer. And every day I pray and declare these scriptures every single day. Every single day. I'm on day 142 of fighting breast cancer. And every day without wavering, I have those scriptures plastered on my bathroom mirror. I look at myself in the mirror and I declare these scriptures and I pray these scriptures over myself because in my times of weakness, he is made what? Strong. Number four, I could talk about that forever, but I want to get to praying because I feel like there's some people on here who need life spoken over them. Get them in here, tag them below, share this. We're fixing to declare life because it is your mouth that's going to get you out of this moment that you're in. Your mouth is what determines how the mountain moves. Your mouth is what determines what this thing looks like in your life. What are you going to allow to overwhelm you? Are you going to allow the situation to overwhelm you, or are you going to allow the Savior to overwhelm you? Message me. We ain't having none of that. We ain't having none of that, Jesse. Sorry. You ain't coming on here to spam us. So, number four, keep waiting. Keep waiting. Keep waiting is number four. How you wait will activate faith or fear in your heart. I want to say that again. How you steward this moment while you continue to claim the word of God in your life, no matter what it looks like, no matter what it feels like, no matter what it sounds like, I'm not moved by what I hear. I'm not moved by what I see. I'm not moved by what I feel. That's what faith says. I believe the word of God. Faith says God said it. I believe it. That settles it. I'm standing on the word of God. How you wait, how you steward this moment right now is going to determine whether or not it will activate faith or fear in your heart. It shifts an atmosphere or it shapes an atmosphere. Fear will overwhelm you or faith will overwhelm you. How are you stewarding this moment right now? How you cultivate this moment? Every storm comes with an opposition or an opportunity. How are you going to steward it? How are you going to wait? How are you going to cultivate this thing? Because it is up to you, up to you, up to your mouth. You are in, I tell people all the time, I'm not in control of this situation, cancer, but I am in control of my mind and I am in control of my mouth. And I refuse to waste a moment. I refuse to waste a season. I can sit around all day. I said it from the beginning. I told Brandon the moment that they called me, I said, we will not sit in depression during the season. I will not lose a year of my life. A year of my life. It's going to, according to doctors, it's going to take about a year to get this whole thing settled. I'm believing that it's going to be a whole lot less. They're telling me that I'm going to have radiation, 30 rounds of radiation afterwards for 6 weeks, 5 days a week, back to back, 6 weeks, 30 rounds of radiation after surgery is done. And I'm believing that I'm not going to need that radiation, because if God is already performing miracles and taking tumors out miraculously, and he's already shrinking tumors that shouldn't be shrunk, and he's already doing all of these things, and tests are coming back completely different than what they thought, I'm believing, just like I believed all of the other things they said couldn't happen but God, and has happened, I'm believing I'm not going to need radiation, right? But I told Brandon from the beginning, I said, we will not sit up in our bed being depressed through this whole thing. We're not going to sit up in bed and grieve and be depressed and waste our days and our months and our moments. We are going to find joy in the journey. We are going to cultivate this thing. We are going to put it out there. We are going to be unfiltered. We're going to walk other people through this. We are going to watch God perform a miracle and make a movement out of the mountain. And I refuse to steward this thing wrongly. How you steward the waiting is going to determine whether or not it will activate faith or fear in your life. I need you to hear that. So we're no longer waiting. We're claiming it's here. I want somebody to type below, I'm not waiting anymore. I'm claiming it's here. Type it below right now. We're fixing to pray. I'm not waiting anymore. I'm claiming it is done because God already did it. Jesus already paid the price. It is finished. No more will I sit and wait. No more will I try to prove myself. No more am I trying to find a way to get my healing and prove that I am worthy and strive towards this thing. From here on out, I am not waiting. I am claiming it's done. From here on out, I am believing what the word of God says. And that says that as a child of God, I can stand boldly before the throne. And whatever I ask, believe believing it, I will receive it. Father, I thank you right now. Go ahead and drop those prayer requests right now. Drop them. We're fixing to pray. Get people in here. Father, I am believing right now that this word has penetrated the hearts of your people right now, whether they know God, whether they just jumped on here and are listening to the sound of my voice and are experiencing a moment right now. I am believing that this word was for somebody, that it is going to shift their mindset, that it is going to shift their believing. It is going to shift the things that they believe. It is going to shift the things that they speak. It is going to shift what they focus on. It is going to shift what they meditate on. God, I thank you right now that they refuse to lose. I thank you right now that they refuse to lose because Jesus already won. How can they lose when Jesus already did it? How can God not be a man of his word? God, I speak into their life right now. No matter what it is they are facing, no matter what kind of doctor's report, diagnosis, symptoms, situations, reality that they are going through this morning, I speak right now the life of God over their digestive systems right now, over their minds right now, over cancer right now. I speak the word of God over any type of chronic pain and migraines and anxiety. I speak it right now over them in Jesus' name. They are no longer waiting for their healing. They are claiming it is finished. They will not give up. I speak it over them now. You will not give up, baby. You will not lose this battle. You will not lose this situation. You are an overcomer. I declare that over you in Jesus' name. You overcome because Christ already overcame. You are in control because God is in control. And greater is he who is in you than he who is in the world. This is a test for the testimony that you are fixing to give. I know that sounds cliche, but this is about more than just your life. This is about the millions, the thousands, the hundreds, the family, the friends, the people that you are going to come into contact with. I declare it right now that your story is going to help others get free. Your story and how you cultivated this moment is going to help others get free in Jesus' name. Neuropathy has to go. Depression has to go. PTSD has to go in Jesus' name. Bacteria infections has to leave bodies right now in Jesus' name. Autoimmune diseases have to go. Infertility has to go. Hiatal hernias have to go. Slipped discs have to go back into place in Jesus' name. Chronic pain, I speak to you now in Jesus' name, and I say you have to line up to the word of God. I speak over you right now, and I say that you are brave and you are courageous during this season. You are brave and you are courageous during this season. You are not weak. You are not weak. You are strong in Jesus' name. Your body responds to medication in supernatural ways. Just how my body has responded to medication in supernatural ways, your body is going to respond to medication in supernatural ways. I speak to those of you who are going through chemotherapy and treatment, and I speak life over your body in Jesus' name. You are not sick. You will not throw up every day. You will not have constipation every day. You will not have swelling every day. You will not have shakes every day. You will not have night sweats every day. I speak over your body right now. Your nails will not fall off. Your nails will not turn black. You will not get infections under your nails. You will not have mouth sores in Jesus' name. I speak the life of God over your body. You will respond to chemotherapy supernaturally. Your doctors will be marveled at how you are going through this thing. You will have energy in Jesus' name. The life of God will breathe into your body. You are not fatigued every day. You are not able to sit in bed every day, you are able to get up and do what God has called you to do in the same way that I am still able to stand up and lead worship and minister and do what I do because of the supernatural ability of God. You are doing it in Jesus' name. You are overcoming this thing supernaturally. Put your hand over your heart. Say, I am overcoming this thing supernaturally. I don't have to receive the reports of the doctors. I don't have to receive the symptoms of chemo. I don't care how many people have been through chemo. I don't care how they've gotten through it. I don't care what the doctors say. I am different because I'm a child of God. That's what I had to say every day. I've not had mouth sores. I've not thrown up one time. I've not had my nails have any issues with infection or falling off or bruised or anything like that. I have had some things. I have had horrible things, but they have been way less than what the doctors anticipated. And even when those other symptoms come on me, guess what I'm doing? I'm laying my hands on myself and I'm saying, you will not have night shakes. You will not have night sweats. You are strong. You are able. You have energy. You are not in pain. Your bones will not hurt you every day. You are able to function. You are able to live your life. You've got to lay your hands on yourself and begin to speak the word of God, the word of God, the life of God. God, I speak it now in Jesus' name. I declare that they won't give up. I declare that they will believe in the report of the Lord. I declare that they are an overcomer. I declare that they are a living testimony. They are a living miracle, that they will come out of this thing in ways that the doctors never thought, never imagined, didn't think it could happen. And it will be written down on their reports that this was a miracle from God. A miracle from God. Now I'm going to speak over you the scriptures that I speak over me every single day, every day, every day. Every single day I speak these scriptures and I look at myself in the mirror and they're written on my mirror. They're posted on my mirror and I speak these specific scriptures every day over myself and I'm going to post them today to my Instagram and my Facebook and I want you to save every picture and I want you to print them out and I want you to put them on your mirror and I want you to speak over yourself. This is what has helped me get through this season supernaturally. The word of God is alive and it breathes breath of God into your body. So are you guys ready to speak the scriptures, to pray the scriptures? We're going to pray the scriptures now. We've declared, we've listened to the word. We're going to pray the scriptures now. If you're ready, give me a heart party, tag somebody, share this. Somebody needs this. They're going through hopeless situations and they need to know that they are not hopeless. That Jesus, the one who is able to do all things, can come in and change a situation that seemed impossible. So let's pray scriptures. Here we go. I see the heart party. Mark 11:24 says, whatever you ask in prayer, believing you will receive them. This is how I do it every morning. This is how I do it every morning. Alyssa, everything that you ask in prayer, believing you will receive it. Mark 11:24 says that. So right now I am praying over this specific situation. Now you speak it out of your mouth. What are you believing for? I want you to speak out of your mouth what you're believing God for right now. God, I am believing that I am able. I am believing that I am strong. I am believing that I am not in pain. I am believing that I am not fatigued. I am believing that I don't have to go through hot flashes. I am believing that you are protecting my fertility during this treatment. I will have babies. I will have multiple babies. I am able to see God shift this thing in ways that doctors said couldn't be done. You said, Lord, in Mark 11:24, I can ask in prayer, believing in anything, and I can receive it if it's according to your will. And so, Lord, I am thanking you for healing in their life. I am believing with them. I am agreeing with them right now in their life. They have the things that they are standing for. They have the things they are declaring out of their mouth. They have the things that they are standing in faith for. In Jesus' name, it is done. In 2 Corinthians 10:5, it says we can demolish every deceptive fantasy that opposes God. So right now, in Jesus' name, we demolish thoughts of negativity. We demolish thoughts of fear. We demolish thoughts of anxiety and worry and chaos in Jesus' name. I take authority over thoughts that contradict the word of God. I take authority over doctor's reports that have come to flood the minds of your people. And I thank you, God, your word says in 2 Corinthians 10:5, we can demolish every deceptive fantasy that opposes you. If it doesn't line up to your word, God, we cast them out. If it doesn't agree with your word, we don't stand on it. If it doesn't agree with your word, we're not accepting it over our lives. Disease is not ours. We know the deliverer. We know the healer. In Jesus' name, we know the one that can turn this thing around. He is a miracle working God. And we take authority over thoughts that would keep us up in the middle of the night. We take authority over thoughts that would keep us up in the day and cause us not to rest, Father God. I thank you that we don't have to meditate on it, because in 2 Timothy 1:7, God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power and love and a sound mind. I speak sound minds in Jesus' name. We are not fearful over the situation. We are not fearful over the season. We are not fearful over this thing that we're having to go through. We have a sound mind. We know peace, the person. His name is Jesus. So God, I speak over those who have allowed fear to rule them in such a way that it has kept them sick. It has kept them up. It has kept them meditating on the reports. It has kept them meditating on the labs and the biopsies and the scans and the treatments. It has stolen things from them mentally. God, I speak a sound mind over them in Jesus' name, because they know peace, the person. His name is Jesus. It's not a place. It's not a paycheck. It's not a position. It's a person. And God, we don't have to walk in fear because of that. We don't have to walk in fear because Galatians 3:13 says, Christ paid the full price to set us free from the curse of the law of sin and death. He set us free from it. So Father, I thank you right now that we can stand in that freedom. We can stand in the knowing that it is finished. Somebody type below, it is done. It is done. I thank you, God, that it is done. That you paid the full price for not only my salvation, but for my healing, for their healing, for their salvation, for the fullness of life inside of them, for their joy, for their understanding, God, for their peace, Father God, for their relationships. You paid the full price. So we don't have to worry. It is done. Romans 8:11 says, God's spirit of resurrection lives inside of me, and that he will raise my dying body to life. Somebody put their hand on their chest right now and say, his spirit of resurrection lives inside of me. He will raise my dying body to life. I am not accepting sickness. I am not accepting death. The resurrection life of Christ is inside of me. He is breathing life into your situation. He is breathing life into your health, into your body, into your cells, into your organs, into your bones. He is breathing life into your heart. He is breathing life into your blood. He is breathing life into your mental state, into your peace, into your relationships. He is breathing life into it. The resurrection life of Christ is inside of you. So how can you lose? How can you lose in Jesus' name? Jeremiah 30:17 says that he will restore health to me. He will restore health to me. Say that out loud. He will restore health to me. God, I thank you. You're restoring health to every area of my body that is lacking right now. Every symptom, everything that I am having to walk out a process with right now, you are restoring health to my body. You are quickening me in Jesus' name. You are rejuvenating the cells in their body. You are rejuvenating them in Jesus' name. In every area that is lacking, you are making up for it, Lord. You are restoring health to their body, because Joshua 21:45 says, not one of the promises that the Lord spoke failed, but that all of them came to pass, right? All of them. Right now, type it down below. All of them. God, you said not one of your promises failed. You said that all of them come to pass according to Joshua 21:45. So I declare right now every promise of health, every promise of peace, every promise of restoration, every promise of rejuvenation, every promise of freedom right now is coming to pass in their life because they are opening their mouth right now while I am praying and they are agreeing with me for their self. You are the only one that can agree over your body. You are the only one that can speak over your body. I can speak over it, but there is something different about you opening your mouth. I am reading scriptures that I read over. I'm praying right now. The same way that I pray over myself every day with these scriptures. I'm teaching you something that can change your life. I have seen miracles because this is what I practice. You can see miracles because this is what you can practice, because God's word is true. So God, we thank you that your promises are true and they don't fail. Speak it right now. Your promise is true. It doesn't fail. According to Joshua 21:45, all of them come to pass. So I thank you, God. I don't care what the doctors say. You are higher than the name of a doctor, than the name of a disease, than the name of a disorder, than the name of a treatment, than the name of a medicine. You are higher. Your ways are higher. You are stronger. You are able. And I believe that all of your promises are coming to pass in my life. Deuteronomy 30:19 says, choose you this for, therefore, this day, life or death, blessing or cursing. So right now, I choose life. This is what I say every day as I look at myself in the mirror. Deuteronomy 30:19. God, I choose life. Say it right now. I choose life. I don't choose death. I choose blessing. I don't choose cursing. In Deuteronomy 30:19, you gave me a choice. You gave them a choice, God. You told me to choose. So today I'm choosing life. I am choosing to live. I am choosing to live my life full. Full. According to your will, I am choosing blessing, not cursing. I am choosing what you have for me, Father God. And I thank you right now that the life of God is present in my life because I know who you are. I am in the I am. Say it right now. I am in the I am. I speak life over them right now and not death. I speak over every single person. Yes, I'm posting all of these scriptures to my Instagram and Facebook. And in the same format that I have them pasted all over my mirror. So the same format, I printed them off, I cut them into little cards, pasted them on my mirror, and I've done this for 142 days during my cancer walk and have seen God do miracles by speaking these scriptures over me 4 times a day. Yes, honey, 4 times a day. I'm speaking life over me more than I'm speaking death. I am taking in the word of God 4 times a day when I first wake up in the morning, at breakfast, at dinner, and at night. I look at myself in the mirror and I speak these scriptures. I'll be posting them. You guys print them off. So thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God, that they are choosing life and not death in Jesus' name. 1 Peter 2:24 says that our instant healing flowed from his wounding. Our instant healing. So Father, I thank you. I am healed. Say it right now. I thank you. I'm healed. Instantly healed. I'm not waiting for my healing. I don't care if I see it. I don't care if they see it. I don't care if they feel it. I don't care if they hear it. I don't care what symptoms are telling them otherwise. They are healed because God's word says our instant healing flowed from his wounding, not our progressive healing, not our maybe healing, not our sort of healing, not our kind of healing. I know it sounds weird. I know it sounds stupid. I know their reality tells them otherwise. I know their symptoms tell them otherwise. I know I'm feeling things right now. I know I'm speaking life over them right now as I'm going through symptoms, but I am healed. I am not sick. I am not diseased. I am overcoming because he already overcame. My instant healing flowed from his wounding. Their instant healing flowed from his wounding. I declare that they will live and not die and declare the works of the Lord according to Psalm 118:17. They will live and not die and declare the works of the Lord. I will live and not die and declare the works of the Lord. I don't care what the doctor says. I don't care what the reports say. I don't care what they are facing right now. They will live and not die. And they will declare the works of the Lord, because greater is he who is in them than he is who is in the world. They are able because they've got God on their side. They are not like any normal patient. They are not like any normal cancer patient, any normal person who has an autoimmune disease, any normal person who is going through infertility, any normal person who is struggling with slipped disc and chronic pain. They are not like any normal person that has PTSD. They are not like any normal person that is having anxiety. They are not like any normal person that's having organ failure. They are not like any person who has normal person who has a blood disorder. They are a child of God, and they will live and not die. They will declare the works of the Lord. They will overcome this because he already overcame it. In Jesus' name, I thank you that you paid the full price to set us free from the curse of the law, God. In Galatians 3:13, I thank you, God. In Revelations 12:11, it says that we conquer through the blood of Jesus and the word of our testimony, God. We cannot just rely on the blood, but we have to open our mouth and let our testimony flow forth before we see it happen. God, we partner our words with your blood. Say that right now. We partner our words with your blood. God, I won't allow my mouth. I won't allow my mouth to partner with the situation. I won't allow my mouth to partner with the doctors. God, I'm speaking over them right now. Their mouth will not partner with the doctors. It will partner with the blood of Jesus, the price that was already paid, the healing that was already paid, the deliverance that was already paid, the freedom that was already paid, God. We are partnering with your word and your blood, God. We are allowing our mouth to be a living testimony. That's how we conquer. Your word says that's how we conquer, God. So I pray right now that they will protect their mouth, that they will protect their words, that they will protect the things that they are speaking over themselves, that they will understand that their words have life or death in the power of their tongue, and they will not allow their tongue to partner with what the doctors have said, with what their symptoms are saying, with the process that they are truly going through, but they will partner with what the word of God says, because Hebrews 10:23 says we can wrap our heart tightly around the hope that lives within us, knowing God always keeps his promises. There he goes again, saying he always keeps his promises. This is my number one scripture that I proclaim so hard throughout this season. God, I can wrap my heart tightly around the hope that lives within me. On the days that I am laying in bed shaking from chemo, on the days that I'm hurting, my body is hurting, on the days that I don't know how I'm gonna get out of bed, on the days that I truly feel like I'm dying, I can wrap my heart around the hope that is within me, because he always, always, always keeps his promises. He will not fail you. He will not leave you. He will not forsake you. He will not fail his word. He will not lie. He will always, 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 always keep his promises. What's the key here? Do you believe it? Well, Alyssa, I've seen people die of breast cancer. Alyssa, I've seen people die of these diseases. Alyssa, I've got a bad report. Alyssa, they've given me a 2-year death sentence. Alyssa, you don't understand. No. What do you believe? Do you believe that he always keeps his promises? Is your mouth agreeing with him more than it's agreeing with the doctor? I just talked to somebody just this weekend. We were in Charlotte, and this girl, I shared my testimony of how God is performing miracles in my life. And she said, my sister, she sent me her Instagram. It was just a powerful testimony. They gave her, I want to say, a year or less than a year to live. And she had ovarian cancer and heart failure. Ovarian cancer and heart failure. She looked like a skeleton. She looked like death. And they weren't expecting her to live. But God, without one chemo treatment, without one radiation treatment, without one heart transplant. She was completely healed. 2 years later now, living her life, healed, healthy, and whole. It was a miracle because they stood on what they believed. It is a miracle in my life that tumors are disappearing and my whole treatment is changing because I'm standing on the word of God. I can wrap my heart tightly around the hope that lives within me, knowing he always keeps his promises, and I can see it for me because I believe it. You can see it for you only if you believe it. Mark 11:24, whatever I ask in prayer, believing I will receive. Not just what I say, just to say it. What I believe. What do you believe? Do you believe? Do you believe? So God, I speak it over them right now. That the word says in Psalm 107:20 that you spoke the words, be healed, and we were healed and delivered from death's door. So I speak right now in the name of Jesus. Be healed in Jesus' name. Be healed in Jesus' name. Receive it now in Jesus' name. In the same way you receive salvation, receive your healing. Lay your hands on your heart and say, I receive my healing in Jesus' name. I want y'all to send me messages. I'm prophesying right now. God is doing a healing work right now in your body. You're going to message me later and you're going to say, Alyssa, you don't understand. I've been having these chronic pains. I've been having this PTSD. I've been having this anxiety. I've been having these symptoms from treatment. And all of these symptoms have left me as I begin to believe, as I begin to declare the word. Send me your testimonies. I want to hear it as you begin to practice this. I want to hear it. I want to share it with our crew here. I want to put it out there that people are seeing this happen. Hebrews 10:23 was that previous scripture. I want you to turn it in. I'm telling you, I'm prophesying right now. God is doing a healing work in somebody's body right now. A healing work in somebody's body. I'm going to go out on a limb right now. I feel the Holy Spirit. And I don't prophesy much on here. I prophesy in person. I operate this way. But I am prophesying right now. There's somebody on here right now. And you have just been recently diagnosed with cancer. And they are telling you that you are going to lose certain things and that you have a timeline on your life. But I am telling you right now, under the power of the Holy Spirit, and I know that this is could be for anyone, but I'm telling you, grab a hold of it. If this is for you, you've been recently diagnosed. They said you're going to lose certain things and that you have a timeline put on your life. God said, if you will take a hold of these scriptures and you will begin to speak them, there is going to be a supernatural anointing that is going to take over. And you are going to walk through this thing in a way that they never expected you to walk through. Just like me, all of the tests are going to start coming back differently. All of the things are going to start coming back differently. They're going to have to revise the plan. They're going to have to go back on what they said. They're going to try to say it was chemo. They're going to try to say it was certain things. But as you trust God and go through the process, you're going to watch them backstep their stuff. They're going to backstep their treatment. They're going to backstep the death sentence. They're going to backstep the diagnosis. You're going to watch it happen. And when you start seeing it happen, I want you to message me. Because I'm telling you, somebody specifically is on here. You've been laid up in bed, worried about this and stressed out about it. But I'm telling you right now, God said, if you will hear the word of the Lord and believe that he is able, you're going to see doctors marvel at your situation. I don't know if it's on Instagram or Facebook. So Father, I thank you. I speak, be healed in Jesus' name. And they were healed and delivered from death's door according to Psalm 107:20, God. And so I pray right now over every person under the sound of my voice. I thank you, God, that you're protecting their minds in the waiting, that they are claiming in the waiting. They are claiming in the waiting. They're claiming your word in the waiting. God, they are trusting you. They are resting in you. They are believing in you. They are not distraught. They are not destroyed. They are not forgotten. They are not forsaken. They are right where you have them to be, and you are making a way where there seems to be no way. I declare life. I declare strength. I declare the joy of the Lord right now. Some of y'all have been depressed, laid up in your bed for a long time, and I declare and speak right now, the joy of the Lord is your strength. The joy of the Lord is your strength. God, joy is not the same as happiness. Happiness is ours to produce. Joy is yours. It's a fruit of the Spirit. Father, we thank you that we don't have to produce it. We just simply have to bear it. We just simply have to receive it. God, I declare the joy of the Lord over them. They can have joy in the midst of this situation. They can have joy in the midst of the journey. In Jesus' name, just like I have chosen to have joy in the journey, I thank you that they can choose to have joy in the journey. I thank you, Father God. I thank you, Father God. Now lay your hand on your chest and say, I thank you, it's done. I always end my prayers thanking him for who he is. I don't spend hours asking what I want. I spend time declaring scriptures just like we did. Declaring scriptures and thanking him. You will see your life changed and your situation changed if you declare the scriptures and thank him in advance. Two things that faith does. It speaks and it believes. Speaks is the action. Believing is the attitude. If you will declare the scriptures, pray the scriptures, Mark 11:24, whatsoever you ask in prayer, believing you will receive them, but you have to ask according to his will. That's what the word says, according to his will. If you will pray the scriptures and thank him in advance, you will see things change. And that's how I know. That's how I've done it. I pray the scriptures, not what I want. I pray the scriptures over my situation, and I thank him in advance. So we have prayed the scriptures. These are scriptures I pray every day, 142 days of fighting cancer. And I've seen God do miracles. I'm going to post these scriptures exactly how, the same format that I have on my mirror. I'm going to post them today, save the photos, print them on your mirror, start practicing them. I get on here every Wednesday morning, typically 8 a.m., but yesterday chemo hit me harder, so we got on here at 9. And we are going to continue praying every single Wednesday morning together and declaring scriptures and thanking him in advance. So we're going to thank him now. We've prayed the scriptures. We're going to thank him. So God, I thank you. Now you say it. I thank you that you are faithful. I thank you that you are faithful. I thank you that you are able, God. I thank you that you've never left me during this season. I thank you that you are true to your word. Thank him right now in the midst of your situation. I thank you, God, that you are in control. I thank you that you are ordaining my steps, that you are putting them in order. I thank you that you give me ears to hear and eyes to see. I thank you that you give them ears to hear and eyes to see. I thank you that you are protecting their minds. I thank you that you are a way maker, that you are a miracle worker, that you are a promise keeper. I thank you that you are a man that cannot lie. I thank you for your word. I thank you for what you've promised us. I thank you for giving us words of life to speak over ourselves. I thank you, God, that you are good, that you are a good father, even when things don't look good. I thank you that you are faithful, even when their faith isn't full. I thank you, God, that you are there with them, even when they don't know or see or feel you, that they have never been left, God. I thank you that you are putting things in place right now, that you are healing them in Jesus' name. I thank you that you are a healer. I thank you, God, that you turn tides when we don't understand it, that you can take hopeless situations and make them good, that you can take a mess, the mud of our life, and make ministry out of it. God, Jesus took mud and created with it and saw people healed, blind eyes open, mute tongues speak, Father God. I thank you that the mud of our life is healing our life. Listen to that. I thank you that the mud of our life is healing our life. I thank you that our dirt hasn't stopped us. Destiny is written there. I thank you, God, that even with the things we are going through, it could be a whole lot worse. It could be a whole lot worse. So I thank you for where I am. I thank you for this moment. I thank you for their moment. I thank you for their moment right now in Jesus' name. I thank you for it, God. I thank you they're stewarding it correctly. I thank you that they're cultivating it correctly. I thank you that their words are lining up to your yes. Your word is yes and amen. I thank you that their amen collides with your yes in Jesus' name. I love you guys. Thank you for praying with me today. Thank you for spending time with me this morning. I just felt like I needed to come on here and pray the way that I pray every day. I'm teaching you guys something right now in the middle of a moment for me. If you'll grab a hold of it, it'll change your life. If you will pray the scriptures more than you pray your desires, and if you will thank him in advance, even when you don't see it, you will watch God work. And every Wednesday morning at 8 a.m., 9 a.m., depending upon how I feel from chemo the day before, we will be here praying. We will be here praying. I try to go on Tuesday nights at 9 p.m. for live. It's probably going to shift depending upon how I feel. I do plan on coming on here Thursday night, 9 p.m., Thursday or Friday night, 9 p.m. Just be watching for me. We're going to do our unfiltered chats. I love you guys. I'm believing with you guys. I'm agreeing with you guys. Open your mouth and speak the word of God. Follow me. Sign up for my MentorU. We kick off this Monday. You can sign up any day of the week, any time of the month, any time of the day. But from the moment you sign up, you get a month with me and my crew. We get on lives every Monday night at 9 p.m. for a personal mentorship Zoom call where we're Zoomed in. All of my crew is there. We're pouring into each other. We're unfiltering real life things. It starts this Monday. I'm kicking it back off. And you can sign up right here where my link is at. My Cash App's there. My link is there for MentorU. My link for my book is there. You can get it on Amazon and Kindle. You guys, I am here for you. I've got a podcast. I've got a YouTube. I'm here praying with you on Wednesday mornings. I'm here throughout the week. There is no reason why you have to stay where you are. No. I have made it my life's goal to help you be the best you that you can be, to pick you up out of your dirt and see destiny come to pass. And that is who I am, unfiltered. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. I'm going to tell you the hard things, but I'm also going to help you realize you don't have to stay there. Don't have to stay there. So sign up for that mentorship, MentorU down there. It's $25 a month. And that's not much to invest in your life and to be connected to a crew for an entire month and have weekly Zoom calls. I send out devotionals. I send out encouragement. I send out challenges. And I'm going to have you also be a part of a private Facebook group where only our crew is involved there. We're building this thing. This is a new thing. So we're building it. So it's going to be smaller and more intimate, which means I get to pour into you guys more one-on-one while it stays smaller. But you just watch. It's not going to stay small. It's going to keep growing and growing. So jump in on it now. Jump in on it now. I love you guys. I'm going to go now. My daughter is home today. We just got over COVID in our house. Luckily, me, Brandon, and my baby did not catch it because of Jesus, but my oldest had it. She was isolated. She's already back in school. They had her quarantined for 10 days, but they have us quarantining for 20 days. We've been tested 3 or 4 times and have been negative every time. So, but my daughter doesn't get to go back to school until March 1st. So we're coming up on it, but she's doing a virtual school, homeschool here with me. So I've got to get her started on her schoolwork. But I love you guys. I love you guys. Have a blessed day. Keep the word of God in your mouth. And I'm going to post these scriptures later on. You guys print them off, paste them to your mirrors, do exactly what I did with you this morning, every single day. And even if you're not sick, start speaking these things over you now, man. If there's one thing I've learned during this journey, I will never stop declaring healing scriptures over myself every day. Why do we wait until we get sick to finally start declaring healing scriptures? If we would start declaring them now before sickness ever comes, what could our life look like? What could our life look like? So now it's a daily practice for the rest of my life till I am dead and 6 feet under in the ground. I will always declare healing scriptures, whether I am the healthiest I've ever been or the sickest I've ever been. It's a daily practice. So you guys practice it even if you don't have something in your life that you are going through physically at this moment. But I love you guys. I'm praying over all of your stuff. I'll see you guys in a couple days for Unfiltered Chat, 9 p.m. I always promote it. So go follow me on Instagram at thealissaholt. Go check out my podcast, Unfiltered with Alyssa Holt, YouTube. Follow all the things. I'm trying to get my YouTube up to 1,000 subscribers. I think we're at 625. But the moment that I get 1,000, I can start going live on YouTube too. So you guys go follow me on YouTube. Brandon and I are posting a video today on my YouTube. New doctor's reports, new things that I have not shared with you guys yet. It's going to be all on my YouTube channel. Go follow it because it's about our infertility appointment or with the fertility doctor and some things that the doctor said about the next steps of my process. So go watch it to see what we're believing for. You can continue watching miracles happen. Subscribe so that we can start going live over there. Okay, I'm done. I love you guys. See you guys later.